Greetings of the day. I welcome you all for the second session. Let us summarize the last session. We studied analytical or exact approach to find out terminal velocity of the parachutists, where we considered the simple mathematical model based on Newton's second law of motion. So as we know that formula for second law of motion is F is equal to ma, that is equation number one, where F is force, m is mass and a is acceleration. Now to reformulate the equation 1 into simple mathematical form, we will divide both the sides of equation 1 by m and we get a is equal to f divided by m, because a is independent variable, that is acceleration is independent variable to be located on left hand side of the equation, f is forcing function and m is system parameter, hence it is located on right hand side of equation. So as we know that acceleration is nothing but rate of change of velocity with respect to time, we can replace this a from equation 2 with dv by dt, and we can substitute it in equation 2, get equation 3 as dv by dt is equal to f divided by m, that is a was replaced with dv by dt. So now if we consider the net forces acting on the system or the body of the parachutist, it consists of two sub forces, that is upward and downward. You can see the diagram of parachutist here. Upward force is designated as Fu and downward force is designated as Fd. So downward force is nothing but the pull due to gravity, hence it is written as Fd is equal to mg. And another one is due to air resistance, that is upward force Fu is equal to C into V, where C is drag coefficient and V is velocity. That's why the formula for Fu is written as C into V. So now as we know that net force acting on the body, the parachutist body, is nothing but difference between downward force and upward force. We can write it as F is equal to mg minus c, and then we'll put this value of F in equation 3 to reformulate equation 3 as dv by dt is equal to mg minus cv divided by m. Simplifying this with this equation, we get dv by dt is equal to g minus c divided by m into v. So now with an intention to find out terminal velocity of the parachutist to be attained after sufficiently long time, we need to integrate equation number 8, this equation number 8 with respect to V and T. So initially we will assume that when T is 0, the velocity will be 0. So after integrating equation 8, we get the equation which is highlighted in green color, which is written as V at T is equal to G, that is gravitational acceleration, into M divided by C into 1 minus e raised to minus C divided by M into T. Now putting the values of T starting from 0 with the step size or the interval of time as 2 seconds, we found the velocity. It was observed that after a sufficiently long time, a constant velocity called terminal velocity of 53.39 meters per second is reached, which is shown here. When we substitute the value of t in this equation, which is starting from 0 with step size 2, we get the corresponding response of velocity, which is shown here. And after sufficiently long time, the terminal velocity of 53.39 was attained. After this point, the velocity remains constant. Now let us see the limitations of exact approach. The approach which we have adopted to solve the model of parachutist just now is called as exact approach because it involves the calculus. As we studied that solving the mathematical models using exact approach involves the calculus. To find out rate of change of velocity with respect to time, we applied the integration to the mathematical model, which was merely consist of fewer factors or parameters, which was forcing factor F, mass of the body, drag coefficient as C. So there were only three factors which was consisted in the mathematical model, which was very simple. But in real time engineering practice, unfortunately, there are many mathematical models which are very complex in nature, which involves numerous parameters and factors that cannot be solved using exact approach, because the computation of calculus becomes very tedious and time consuming. So now in current session, we will be discussing about numerical or approximation approach for dealing with the same problem of parachutist. So as mentioned previously, that numerical methods are those in which the mathematical problem is reformulated so that it can be solved by arithmetic operations. So now let us consider the case of parachutist, where the response of velocity is plotted along the plotted with respect to the time. So let us consider x-axis, where time is plotted. Let us consider y-axis, where velocity is plotted. So let us consider a point A, where the time at point A is ti, which is initial time, and respective velocity at ti is nothing but v of ti. If we consider the experimental approach or experimentation of the parachutist response, the curve is shown here. That is why it is called as experimental response, which is actual response of the velocity of the parachutist. And then we will consider a straight line which is passing through A as the exact response of the parachutist, where the slope of this line can be written as dv by dt, which we have formulated in the previous session or summary of this session. Now if we consider the approximated response, another straight line we will consider, which is also passing from point A. But then the approximated response and experimental response, where it intersects, that point will be called as point B. And the time at point B will be considered as ti plus 1, and respective velocity is considered as v of ti plus 1. So after this, now we have we know that there are two time instances where ti is initial time and ti plus 1 is the time instant after some time. So that difference between these two times will be considered as dabba t. And along with this, since we got the two velocities, magnitude of velocities at two points, the difference between these two velocities will be considered as dabba v. So dabba t will be written as ti plus 1 minus ti, and dabba v will be written as v ti plus 1 minus v ti. So can we calculate or can we write the slope for the experimental response? Because we know two points, as initial point as A and the later point as B. So if we want to write a slope, we know formula as y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Here we have y2 as v of ti plus 1 minus vti divided by ti plus 1 minus ti. So slope of this approximated response can be written as dabba v divided by dabba t is equal to v of ti plus 1, which is y2, minus v of ti, which is y1, divided by ti plus 1, which is x2, minus ti, which is x1. This approximated response is considered as a straight line. Remember that slope of approximated response depends on the time interval, that is dabba t. Hence, by considering the slope and previous value of p and t, value of v ti plus 1 can be easily determined. This value of v ti plus 1 is nothing but the new value of velocity. So that means to calculate new value of velocity, you need initial time, initial velocity, and the slope of the approximated response. If you reduce the step size of the time, automatically the accuracy of the response of the velocity will increase. So that means lesser the value of step size, more accurate will be the velocity at next point. So along with this, you must remember that dv by dt is equal to limit dabba t tends to 0 dabba v divided by dabba t. So equation 10 represents the reverse process. That is why we can put or we can substitute value of dabba v by dabba t as dv by dt is equal to slope of the approximated response. As I already stated, dabba v and dabba t are the differences in velocity and time computed over the finite interval of time. Vti is velocity at initial time ti. Vti plus 1 is velocity at some later time, that is ti plus 1. Note that dv by dt is approximately equal to dabba v by dabba t because the dabba t is finite. That means equation 10 can be called as finite divided difference approximation of derivative at time ti. That means dabba t is considered to be finite because the time interval between two instances can be kept constant, or it can be kept finite. It can be 2, it can be 4, it can be 6, or even it should be lesser than the, it should be lesser value, a minimum value to get the maximum accuracy. So that means the dabba t is nothing but the step size between two time instances. So now if you consider the equation from analytical approach or exact approach which we had studied in the previous session, that dv by dt is nothing but the exact slope which is depends on g, c, m and the initial velocity v. So if you notice, the terms in the bracket is the right hand side of the differential equation itself. So that is, it provides a means to compute the rate of change of or velocity rate of change or slope of v, or that is velocity. Thus, to transform the differential equation into simple algebraic equation, equation 10 can be substituted in equation 8. We get that. So instead of dv by dt, as in the previous slide we stated that dv by dt is approximately equal to dabba v by dabba t, so we substitute the value of dabba t by dabba v, dabba v by dabba t instead of dv by dt to get this particular equation. So now we can write as v ti plus 1 minus v ti divided by ti plus 1 minus ti is equal to g minus c divided by m into velocity at time ti, that is initial velocity. Now if you compare the two equations, this equation and this equation, you will find that to solve this equation you need help of integration. But if you consider this equation, you just need arithmetic operations. Now our ultimate intention is to find out velocity at time instant when velocity is equal to v ti plus 1. So this equation can be rearranged in such fashion that term v ti plus 1 can only be kept on left hand side, and rearrange other terms we get it as v ti plus 1 is equal to v ti, that is velocity at initial time ti, plus g minus c divided by m, initial velocity v ti, into ti plus 1 minus ti, that is nothing but you can say the dabba t or step size. Thus the differential equation has been transformed into an equation that can be used to determine the velocity algebraically at time ti plus 1 using slope and the previous values of t and t. So this means the approximated approach involves only arithmetic operations. There is no need of any calculus. Hence, numerical method approach is considered to be the easier approach than the exact or analytical approach. So if you are given an initial value of velocity at some point ti, you can be easily able to estimate the velocity at later time t I plus 1. This new value of velocity at t I plus 1 can in turn be employed to extend the computation to velocity at t I plus 2 and so on. Thus at any time along the way, you get formula as new value of velocity is equal to old value of velocity, that is initial value of velocity plus slope into step size. So this approach is basically called as Euler's method or Euler's approach, which is employed for finding out the response of velocity, I mean response of any dependent variable with respect to other factors. Now if we consider one example, using the same example of parachutist, by solving it using approximated approach, the procedure is given here. Perform the same computation as in example 1, but use equation 11 to compute the velocity. Employ a step size of 2 seconds for the calculation. That means dabba t must be equal to 2 seconds. At the start of the computation, consider initial time ti as 0 and the velocity of the parachutist is 0, because if you don't consider this assumption, you will not be able to proceed for the first iteration or first computation or first estimation. So using the same values from equation 1, that is value of g, m and c, equation 11 can be used to compute velocity at ti plus 1, that is 2 seconds. Now if you consider the formula which is given in equation 11, as we know that velocity at ti plus 1, that is velocity at when ti plus 1 is 2, is equal to initial velocity when time is ti plus in bracket g minus c divided by m, velocity at initial point ti bracket complete into step size. So what we will do is we will put this value of this all the values in this equation. So velocity when ti plus 1 is 2 can be calculated as initial velocity, because initial velocity of parachutist is considered to be 0 when ti is 0, plus g, which is gravitational acceleration, which is 9.8, minus c, which is drag coefficient 12.5, divided by m, which is mass of the parachutist, which is 68.1, into 0. Now this 0 is nothing but the initial velocity, which is also 0, into step size, that is ti plus 1 minus ti, that is 2, that is dabba t. So you will get answer as 19.60 meter per second when velocity is time is 2 seconds. So we can say when time is 0, velocity is 0. When time is 2 seconds, velocity is 19.60. Now can we use this velocity to compute velocity when time is equal to 4? Yes. So from the next interval, when time is equal to 2 to 4 seconds, the computation is replaced with the results that v at time is equal to 4 is equal to initial velocity. Now this initial velocity is considered as velocity which is computed in the previous iteration. So 19.60 is considered to be initial velocity for this particular iteration, plus the same values, these values will remain same, only initial value will be replaced by 19.60, and again step size will remain same as 2. So you get answer as 32.00 meter per second. So this iteration, this process can be repeated till you get the constant velocity, as called as terminal velocity. So for now, next iteration, when you consider time at 6, then the initial velocity should be considered as 32. So in the next iteration, this 19.60 and this 19.60 will be replaced by 32, and then you will get the respective velocity. So if you see the values, you will find that when t is 0, velocity is 0, when t is 2, velocity is 19.60, when t is 4, velocity is 32, when t is 6, velocity is 39.85, and so on. So after sufficiently larger time, you will get this constant velocity as 53.39. So I request all of you to calculate, to consider the time interval after 12 also, and you just compute this velocity till you get answer as 53.39. Now if you compare the analytical and exact approach with the approximated approach, what you have to do is you have to consider the values of velocity from the exact approach which was calculated in the previous session, and values of velocity from the approximated approach, and you have to plot both the velocities on the same plot. So consider time on x-axis, plot the respective velocities which we have calculated in exact approach, you will get this particular curve, and again plot the on the same time interval, plot the values of velocity which we have calculated in approximated approach. So you will find that there must be some difference. Why is this difference? Because step size of time which is considered as 2 may be large. If you consider lesser step size, if you consider step size of time as 1, you might get, or not might, but you will definitely get as exact curve as you can get it in analytical solution. Now if you see the why I am telling this, because if you consider values of velocity from the analytical approach, let us go to the previous slides. If you see the values here, values of velocity which we have calculated in analytical approach differs from the approximated approach. So I am asking you guys to plot velocity from this approach and the approximated approach on the same plot to get the curve, and then you will be able to find out the difference. Right? So now we will go to next point. So this can be seen that numerical method captures the essential features of exact solution. It may be somewhat different, but definitely it captures the fundamental features. However, because we have employed a straight line segments to approximate a continuous curving function, there is some difference between two results, but this approximation of straight line can be reduced or can be replaced if you consider the lesser time interval. So on the way to minimize the differences, we use the smaller step size as I already stated. For example, applying equation 11 with time interval result in smaller errors as the straight line segments track closer to the true solution. However, with the aid of computer, large numbers of calculations can be performed easily. So this approach was stated here to just showcase the potential of numerical methods or numerical approach, that is approximated response or approximated kind of approach. But this can be done manually, because if you want to perform the iterations, you need to calculate the same equations again and again with some different values. So you need software analysis or software programming. That is why this subject is associated with programming also. Thus you can accurately model the velocity of falling parachutes without having to solve differential equation exactly. So this is the conclusion, bottom line of the session, that in numerical methods you really don't need the differential equation to be solved using conventional methods, but you can approximate, you can just reformulate it in the form of some simple form, and you can get the answer. Okay, now the assignments for the first week are for A and B batch. The numerical is use calculus to solve equation number 8. For the case where initial velocity, that is V when time is equal to 0, is non-zero. That means initial velocity is to be considered as non-zero. For C and D batch, rather than the linear relationship of equation 6, you might choose to model the upward force on the parachutist as a good as a second order relationship, as upward force is equal to minus c dash into v square, where c dash is equal to a second order drag coefficient. Then using calculus obtained the closed form solution for the case where the jumper is initially at rest, and repeat the numerical calculation in example 3 with same initial conditions and the parameter values. Only thing, the c dash must be considered as 0.225 kg per meters. For g and h batch, compute the velocity of a free falling parachutist using Euler method for the case where mass of parachutist is 80 kg and drag coefficient is 10 kg per second. Perform the calculation from t is equal to 0 till time reaches to 20 seconds with the step size of 1 second. That is, dava t must be 1 second. Use an initial condition that the parachutist has upward velocity of 20 meter per second at t is equal to 0. That means v at t is equal to 0 is 20 meter per second. And then at t is equal to 10 second, assume that the chute is instantaneously deployed so that the drag coefficient jumps to 50 kg per second. For E and F batch, the numerical is a storage tank contains a liquid at depth y, where y is equal to 0, when the tank is half full. Liquid is withdrawn at a constant flow rate Q to meet the demands. The contents are resupplied at a sinusoidal rate, that is 3Q into sin square t. The above equation can be written for this system as change in volume is equal to inflow minus outflow, that is dAy by dx is equal to 3Q sin square t minus Q. Or since the surface area A is constant, you can directly write it as dy by dx is equal to 3 into Q divided by A sin square t minus Q divided by A. Use Euler method to solve for the depth y from t is equal to 0 to 10d with a step size of 0.5d. The parameter values are A is equal to 1200 meter square, Q is equal to 500 cubic meters per d. Assume that the initial condition is y is equal to 0. Now submission mode, for the mode for submission is you can submit either handwritten or type scan copy, that is PDF, of your submission till 9th August 2020. The name of PDF should be your MIS number. Please do not write your name or division or anything else. One student from both the batches should make a PowerPoint presentation of a solution. Then he or she shall be excluded from submission of handwritten or typed scans copy. You can submit directly a PowerPoint presentation. In addition to that, another one student from both the batches should deliver the same presentation and capture the video. Then also he or she shall be excluded from the submission of handwritten or typed scan copy. He or she should submit the video itself, and then that can be uploaded to YouTube channel. Now for link, the link for your submission will be shared to your CR, to which you can upload your video. So here we conclude the first session with introduction to the numerical methods. Thank you so much. From the next session, we will be starting for solution to roots of equation. Thank you.